In this example problem, we calculate the molar solubility of an ionic compound with and without the common ion effect. The problem reads, calculate the molar solubility of calcium fluoride, whose solubility product constant is 1.46 times 10 to the negative 10, in both pure water and in 0.500 molar calcium nitrate solution. We'll start by creating a rise table for the dissolution of solid calcium fluoride in water. When one formula unit of calcium fluoride dissolves in water, it produces one calcium ion and two fluoride ions. We don't need to keep track of solid calcium fluoride in our rise table because solids are not in our equilibrium constant expression. Since we're dissolving calcium fluoride in pure water for part A, we don't have any calcium or fluoride ions to begin with. And since we don't have any product to begin with, our reaction quotient, Q, will be zero, and will be shifting to the right to reach equilibrium. So our change in concentration will be plus X for calcium and plus 2X for fluoride, where X is the moles of solid calcium fluoride that dissolve in 1 liter of solution. This means X is also our molar solubility of calcium fluoride, which is what we're solving for in this problem. At equilibrium, we'll have 1 mole of calcium ions and 2 moles of fluoride ions for every 1 mole of calcium fluoride that was dissolved. For our equilibrium constant expression, the equilibrium constant equals the concentration of our products raised to the power of their coefficients divided by the concentration of our reactants raised to the power of their coefficients. Since our reactant is a solid, it doesn't show up in the equilibrium constant expression. So our solubility product constant expression is just the concentration of calcium ions times the concentration of fluoride ions squared. We can substitute the KSP value given in the problem, 1.46 times 10 to the negative 10th, as well as the equilibrium concentration rho of our rise table into our KSP expression. We need to be careful that we raise both the 2 and the x to the second power for 2x squared. Doing this, we'll get x times 4x squared. This simplifies to 4x cubed. Then we can divide both sides by 4. Then, since x is raised to the third power, we take both sides to the 1/3 power. Completing the calculation, we should get a molar solubility of 3.32 times 10 to the negative 4th moles of calcium fluoride per liter of solution. This is the molar solubility of calcium fluoride in pure water for part A. Now let's look at how the molar solubility changes when we dissolve calcium fluoride into 0.500 molar calcium nitrate solution based on the common ion effect. We begin with the same rise table setup. But this time, we have an initial concentration of 0.5 molar calcium ions from the 0.500 molar calcium nitrate solution. We don't have any fluoride ions to begin with, so our reaction quotient Q will still be zero, and we will still shift to the right to reach equilibrium. So the change will still be plus X for calcium ions and plus 2X for fluoride ions. At equilibrium, we'll have 0.5 plus X for calcium and 2X for fluoride ion concentrations. Our equilibrium constant expression is the same. The solubility product constant equals the concentration of calcium ions times the concentration of fluoride ions squared. But this time, we have 0.5 plus x times the quantity 2x squared. To solve this, we'll want to make a simplifying assumption. We can assume that only a very small amount of calcium fluoride will dissolve in solution. So 0.500 plus x is about equal to 0.500. Making this assumption will simplify the math considerably. So we replace 0.500 plus x with just 0.500. And we square 2x to get 4 times x squared. 0.5 times 4 is 2. So we divide both sides by 2, and then to get rid of this squared on x, we raise both sides to the 1/2 power. Completing the calculation, we get 8.54 times 10 to the negative 6 moles of calcium fluoride per liter of solution. Our molar solubility in calcium nitrate solution has decreased compared to pure water because we already have some calcium ions in solution. This is the common ion effect on solubility.